Hi everybody, my name is Michael for atetsplus.com. I'm a French motion designer and it's my first tutorial. So I hope you will appreciate and understand me. And sorry for my English. So let's have a look at what we're going to be creating today. Nice and cool reconstruction of a car. So let's begin. Okay, open the composition. We see that we have a car and 13 layers with the shadow of the car. So we're gonna animate all the layers at the same time to make it more easier. So select all the layers except of the shadow, go to the frame 10, hit P to bring the position and shift R to bring the rotation. Add a keyframe. Oh. Okay. Go back to zero and move all the layers on the left of the composition and give it some rotation. Maybe 20, no, negative 20. Okay, let's go back to 10 frame and select just the front layer, this one, this one, this one, and this one. Go back to zero and select them and make it come from the right and change the value of the rotation to positive 20. Okay. Okay. Also select the hood. Okay. Go back to zero and make it come from the top of the composition. Okay, and finally take the wheel, go back to zero and make it come from the back. Okay. Now select all the keyframe and hit F9 to ease the movement. Now we're gonna add some light effect. Select all the layers except of the shadow. Go to Effect, Color Correction, Exposure. Okay, add a keyframe. You see that the effect unselected all the layers except the one. We're gonna work on one layer and then copy paste the effect on the other. So we add a keyframe on this part. Go back to 3 frames, make the exposure to 0. I forget it. Go back to the next keyframe and make an exposure about 3. Okay, and move forward maybe 8 frames. And add another keyframe and type 0. So we have light effect when the wheels come on the car. Okay. Now hit U to reveal all the keyframe of the layer. CPU. Select the keyframe, hit Ctrl C to copy, and select the layer 2 to 12, and hit Ctrl V to paste the effect. Okay. Now we have to shift each layer on the timeline to make them arrive one by one. So we're gonna shift them by 3 frames. I think it's enough. So 1, 2, 3. Up. I think this is the best part of this tutorial, no? 1, 2, 3. And the last one, okay. So we have all the layers one by one. Now we're gonna give it some gravity. So take all the layers except the shadow, hit P to bring the position, add a keyframe, and move forward by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 frames, and push it down. Now we see that the car arrived and moved down. Okay. We're gonna undo the F9 effect to make the move more linear. Okay. Then unselect the layer 1 and 2 and move all the keyframe on the right of the timeline by 2 frames to make the wheel comes down first and the car. Now let's have a look about the shadow. We're gonna make it appear when the car touched the ground. Maybe here, hit T to bring the opacity, click on the stopwatch, put 0 for the value, go to the end of the animation and increase it to 100. We got to move it down too. So now we see that the shadow appear when the cars touch the ground. Okay. Now select all the car. Check the blur. And make all the layers 3D. Now it's okay for the car. Let's create the background. So right click, create. New solid, make it at the comp size, make it white or maybe gray, okay, and rename it wall. Click okay. Let's place it under all the layers. Okay, make it 3D too. Hit P to bring the position and move it back on the C space. And and increase the scale. Okay. Now we're gonna hit Ctrl D to duplicate, or you can do it by edit, duplicate, select the new layer, go to layer, settings of the solid. We're gonna rename it floor. We're gonna make it more darker. Click OK at the comp size and new. Now we're gonna take the rotation tool and add some rotation on the X axis. Okay. Hit V to switch on the selection tool and move it down and scale it up too. Okay. Now we're gonna create some light. Right click, create new light, intensity to 100 and the angle at 140. Hit OK, move it up and back onto this base. Okay, now we're gonna have some adjustment layer. Create new adjustment layer, hit enter to rename it and call it curves. Hit OK, go to effect, color correction, curves. Gonna give it some contrast. And some maybe blue. Okay. Now we're gonna have some text layer. Right click, create new text. Write Mustang. Scale it up. And push it. Now we're gonna open the setting. We go to animate. Active 3D per character. Click on it and add another animation. Rotation. Click on it. And we see if we animate the Y rotation, we see that all the letters turn at the same time. So back to when the car touched the floor. Now okay, add a keyframe on the Y rotation, put value 100, hit enter, move maybe 8 frame and put it back to 0. We're gonna give it some opacity, so hit T to bring the opacity, add a keyframe, put 0 and move maybe 2 frame and put it back to 100. Okay. Now I'm gonna import the logo here. Okay. Bring him in the composition, make it 3D2. Now we're gonna toggle the switches and change the transform mode to darker. Okay. And move it on the left. We're gonna also make a mask to hide this part of the logo. Take the ellipse tool, click and drag. You can also hit Alt Control Shift to make a perfect circle and move this point up and this one back. Okay. Now we're gonna create a camera. Right click, create new camera, 35 millimeters. Okay. We're gonna also create a null object. Right click, create null object. We're gonna parenting the camera to the null object. Now go to the null object. Hit R to bring the rotation. We're gonna add the slider control. Go to Effect, Expression, Slider Control. We're gonna add an expression. I'll click on the rotation. Tape wiggle. Parentheses. 4, comma. And we're gonna link it with these settings. Parentheses. Enter. We're gonna go when the wheel touch the ground here, add a keyframe, move forward 2 frames, tape 4, then we're gonna move forward 8 frames and put it back to 0. Okay, now we have one last thing to do. Create the light. I do it with optical flares by Video Copilot, but you can do it with the After Effects flares. But with the Video Copilot plugin, we have multiple choice and make cool things. So I'm gonna do with this plugin. Right click, create new solid, rename it to optical flares, create at the comp size and make it black. Okay, go to effect, video copilot, optical flares, turn the transform mode to screen, put it on the light of the car, make the brightness maybe to 70. Go to the option on the preset browser. We have a lot of flares. I'm gonna choose the motion graphic and this one blue artifact, click OK, and now we're gonna animate the brightness. Click on the stopwatch when the camera movement is end, add a keyframe, tape 0, move forward 2 frames and tape 70, back 2 frames, tape 0 and move forward 4 frames and put it back to 70. Okay. Now we're gonna duplicate this layer, duplicate, and change the position. And put this layer on the bottom of the other. And now if we take a preview, there it is. My name is Michael for a.plus.com. Thanks for watching and goodbye everybody.